If you ask a project manager about the complexity of her project, she most probably will answer confirmative. Yes, it was indeed complex, yes. As long as complexity is used as a black box, the project manager can hide behind this complexity, and if the project would fail, that would be due to its complexity. That's why we are so much interested in understanding project complexity and unravel the black box of complexity. But there's not an objective measure for complexity, in our view. What is considered complex by one might be perceived differently by others. Let's explore this subjectivity. What do you see in this picture? Is it the old lady or the young woman? And the saxophone player or the young lady? And if I would ask you about the complexity of one of the biggest projects ever realized in process industry, what would be your answer? The project director of this mega project was not particularly impressed by the complexity of his projects, and he knew how to manage it. His approach was remarkably simple. In order to manage this huge project, I split it up in 12 sub-projects and I nominated a number of dedicated project managers to manage the interfaces between these projects. In this way, this project was successfully delivered with, at the top of the activities, a workforce of 55,000 workers. You can probably not find a project with more interfaces and stakeholders than in this example. Would you call it complex? Where does your perception come from? Without losing ourselves in psychology, we combine two models developed by Shearer, Stewart and Lusk, combining perceptual judgment and related cues. These cues can be seen as triggers, or in our case, elements of complexity. And in the end, the perceived complexity of a project is created by the selection of certain elements of project complexity, these cues, followed by a judgment of these elements. And then the sum of these forms perceived complexity. Researching this concept, we found that which elements you recognize is related to three main sources. First, perceived impact of that element and the influence you have on that element. Second, your experience. And third, the specific project context or contextual variables. And how you judge either of these three is related to your interests, which in turn are influenced by your role in the project and your personal values. Let's give an example to make things clearer. As a starting project manager, you might have the feeling that some elements causing complexity in your project you can simply not change, and hence you might simply neglect them. Focus on your own circle of influence. Stay in your comfort zone. A more opportunistic project manager might escalate early on in an attempt to still have influence, although in an indirect way. And there are other strategies to choose. It's up to you to choose your approach, and in a way, to pick the right battles. And be aware, being educated as an engineer might introduce some bias. We engineers are typically trained to decompose, and we might be used to find solutions by proper analysis behind our desks. Shouldn't the project environment get more attention? All the sources mentioned earlier contribute, in a certain degree, to the perceived complexity, but the contribution of each of the sources for each individual is situational dependent. So complexity perceptions will be different for different players involved. How to deal with this? Some people are afraid of differences in perceptions. These differences can only lead to trouble. Others see the benefit and value of these different perceptions as they lead to new information about the project and they can lead to more beautiful projects. Ideally, we would plea for the adoption of so-called perception-based management. Differences in perspectives can be helpful once recognized. And this perception-based management starts with the awareness of the different perceptions of complexity. Perception-based management, in our view, is an application of organizational learning using a shared mental model. What do we mean with a shared mental model? The creation of a shared mental model starts with the definition of the project's objectives and a set of general norms and values which express the norms and values lived by the project and the practitioners involved. Project startup meetings and project follow-up meetings, for example, are key enabler to allow the involved practitioners to build such a shared mental model. This shared mental model is meant as a starting point. It will lead to actions for those involved, but it will also be subject of debate, allowing for reshaping the model. The theory that perception-based management is necessary within large construction projects is also supported by Hertog and Westerveld, who mentioned subjectivity within the assessment of uncertainties within large construction projects, and also indicate that different perceptions are the reality of projects. Both issues are addressed with perception-based management. So, perceptions matter. It's our firm belief that one management approach is not applicable for all projects. One size doesn't fit all. We have to fit the approach to the purpose of the project, or in other words, to adapt the management approach to the requirements and the context of the project. Perceived complexity will be the trigger to scale or fit the management approach to the type of project. Horses for courses, so to say.